Watching movies and loving movies and wanting to somehow be a filmmaker, but I didn't really know how to do that because there just wasn't a lot of it going on in Sydney in the 80s. So I had spent a year on exchange at Oregon State University, and I had fallen in love with living in America, and I just kind of made up my mind that I would come over here to Los Angeles. Oh, I'm really happy with the way Collateral came out, Pirates of the Caribbean. You know, every movie has its own experiences, and they're all different, and you know, some are more frustrating than others. 3:10 to Yuma, I was very, very proud of that film, but I didn't get the credit, and I got no credit on it. So you know, there's always something bittersweet about it, but I'm really happy with Tomorrow. Tomorrow was the first film that I actually got to, you know, direct and see all the way through. You know, America, they really encourage ambition, and it's great and a good thing to celebrate, and I think in Australia, you got to kind of be more reserved about your ambition. I remember telling a lot of people that I'm going to be a filmmaker when I grew up, and they would all say, okay, no, really, what do you really want to do? You know, if you really had to fight to be here, really fight, then I think you'd want to stay longer and you'd put up with more, and you know, you put up with all the ups and downs of any industry. You know, the best piece of advice I ever got was my business manager. He said to me, if you're not getting arrested, you're not kicking down enough doors and smashing enough windows, you know. And I really took that to heart and just kind of, you know, went all at it. You know, you gotta get in there.
I've been working media for a long time. I moved over here to New York when I was 21. I wrote a book called How to Tell a Man by His Shoes, which I can, just watch out. And and then ended up becoming the features reporter for NBC's Today Show and Today in New York. In Australia, it's such a beautiful place, and there's so much to keep you there. Life's so good. And I remember thinking, like, I've just got to leave. I've got to force myself out of this paradise and book that ticket and go. And once you arrive in America or in New York, and the energy of that country, which is different but also great, takes you off on a journey, and you end up putting another chapter in the book of your life. And now that I have been working in television and media here, I love when people come over and I can kind of help as much as I can, introduce them to people and, you know, give them the tips of what I learned from the things that worked. Persistence, you know, it is tough sometimes, and anyone who says it isn't is lying, but if you really love what you do and you put in the effort and you're willing to push yourself outside of your comfort zone all the time, then you can achieve whatever it is that you set out to do. Great reward requires great effort, and all the way along towards that success, it feels like you're constantly failing. But if you're a good person and you study the craft, you don't just want to be famous or just want to be rich or whatever it is, but you learn the mechanisms and the mechanics of that industry, and you treat people with respect, you can achieve anything.
I currently work at Pictage, which is a internet company that serves professional photographers. We've got about 12,000 pro photographers that are customers in the US. And this is my fourth internet startup growth company. And before that, I was a venture capitalist and based in Silicon Valley. I grew up in Canberra, sort of Canada, Canberra, and then Sydney. You only have to look at my career, sort of lawyer, venture capitalist, now chief marketing officer, you know, running a big piece of an internet company. It's a winding path, but that's okay. In Australia, you could do a business deal and there may be four other companies that you could do a deal with. Here, there's probably 50. So it's more of a fast pace, like trying to identify who you're going to partner with, who you're going to work with. And that applies if you're trying to build a business relationship or if you're trying to hire employees and so on. I'm very familiar with Advance, and it's a great great organisation. The main benefit is that you get to connect with Australians who are really here, they're in the trenches, they're pursuing their careers. You know, our careers take many winding paths in the US because often you're trying different things and seeing what works. And there's so much to do, there's so many different things to do over here. So to have that opportunity just to kick back with people who, you know, you feel comfortable with because they're like your mates back home and so on, and actually build strong friendships that can benefit you later on.
I've been in Los Angeles for 25 years. I came here sort of on a whim, wanted to sort of travel the world, and 6 months after I got here, landed a job with NBC, and have been on and off with NBC for about 25 years. I think having a global experience is very attractive to a lot of companies. You know, I travel a lot. I think there are people who move around a lot. I always encourage people to take risks. You know, take risks and make that move. If you think it's something you want to do, you always find a way, one way or another. It took me a good year and a half to really settle in. I was very homesick. We speak the same language, but we don't. I think all of us who've been here for a while know that there are certain things that you really have to. You know, is it rubbish or is it trash? Is it, we were just talking about this a little while ago, you know, sort of all those little nuances. And I always say to people, give yourself 2 years, because it takes that long before I think you really sort of are part of, you know, the culture here as well. When I first arrived 25 years ago, I don't think there was anything like this. And I thought at the time it would have been handy to have known that there was some sort of a networking opportunity where you could meet other people and maybe, you know, gain from their experiences. Key words: be daring, be audacious, take risks, know it's going to be different, that's more than one word, and be passionate.